I was just driving home, and as I was going through the lights, I was squinting to see what color the light was. I remember thinking, "What? That's strange." About 6-7 months after I started noticing a change in my vision, I got my legal letter of blindness that stated permanent. I thought, oh my God, what do I do now?
We're treating the untreatable. These people are blind. I have the privilege to try to restore sight.
When I first lost my eyesight, I was barely 23. I was starting the process to become a police officer. And in the midst of all that, that's exactly when this all hit. I called the vision center and I went, and he said, "This is beyond my scope. This is your nerves, it's not your eyes." They ran the MRI and said, "Miss Belton, we have to check you into the hospital for a week and run more tests."
You see the dark area still?
I spent a week every day getting no answers. We don't know, and probably will never know, what I have, but we do know that it was an autoimmune reaction, your body turning on healthy tissue. And for me, that was my optic nerves. At my worst, there was no functional vision. I got light and dark perception and some shadows, but that was it. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't use a phone anymore. I couldn't use a computer. I couldn't transport myself from point A to point B. I lost my job. And for me, that was my lowest point. That was my, oh my God, what do I do now? In that deepest, darkest place, I had to do something different. And I did. There is technology. There are things that can help you. Ways to get on the internet, ways to check your mail. I felt like I was reintroducing myself to the human population, and that sounds silly, but I had felt so detached. That technology gave me the confidence to even get back online. That's how I met my wife. It shifted my life completely. My first date with Julia was probably very atypical. Ours was literally a blind date. I couldn't see her.
Honestly, before I met Vanna, I've never met a visually impaired person. Being around her and cooking with her and how she just genuinely like loved and appreciated my company, I was like, wow, I could really spend the rest of my life with this person. Vanna and I have always been determined to kind of figure out what happened to her, how we could fix it.
Everything that some people would deem crazy or unnecessary, we did. So I asked my neurologist at Hopkins, "Would you all do a surgery on me? It's completely experimental, I understand, and I'll sign all the waivers." It wasn't that long after that same neurologist sent me a 2-line email. It was to clinicaltrials.gov.
"Eyes with loss of vision from retina or optic nerve conditions." And we just both felt like this is it. This is what we've been waiting for.
I gathered my hundreds of pages of medical files, sent it in. Within days, I was told you're a candidate.
When Vanna first came to me, she had a 5-year history of being blind. She was led into the room. She had a white cane that she was using to move side to side so she could see.
Dr. Weiss, he doesn't make false promises. And he said, "I can't guarantee you're gonna get your sight back, but I can guarantee you I'm gonna try."
"We take your stem cells from your bone marrow, we inject them into the optic nerve to treat untreatable retinal and optic nerve conditions."
You have your own stem cells as an adult. They exist in our bodies, and we can harvest that and become your own cure. It is privately funded, meaning patient funded. We did have to figure out, okay, how are we gonna pay for this? Roughly $20,000. And that was what our wedding budget was. Close your eyes for 24 hours and imagine you never get to open them again. We're willing to do more things than you realize.
That decision between wedding and eyesight was a no-brainer. We obviously went for the eyesight.
Okay, we can Just want to wish you the best of luck, lots of love and positivity.
I'm excited. I'm going to wake up in a lot of pain, but it's going to be so much better.
Mm-hmm.
Love you, baby.
Love you, too.
They extracted bone marrow out of my hip. From that bone marrow, they spun it down to get the pure sample of stem cells, and then they injected it into my eyes, into my optic nerve, and then into an IV, and that's it.
A stem cell has the ability to transition into another type of cell, and hopefully by placing it in an area where there's some type of damage, it will transition into the cell necessary to improve function.
Initially, after the surgery, my vision was even worse. I was discouraged. 3 months and 3 days after the surgery, I'm staring across the family room, and it was like a gasp moment.
I looked up and I looked at her, and she's like, I just knew she could see me.
I was like, she's hot. I was excited. I felt lucky. I already knew that inside she was amazing and beautiful, and to actually get to see with defined lines, I was like, damn. She knew with certainty that when we were saying those vows and saying I do, that I was actually looking her in the eye. Tell them what's happening, Julia.
So now we're sitting here at Silver Spring Restaurant.
And she can start making out the letters. So it says Devin.
Self-storage. So this is hope. The stem cells are working.
Yay!
Thanks, Dr. Weiss.
I'm treating people who have been told their whole lives, you have no hope, you're stuck. These people are suffering and somebody has to help them. And it's my privilege to be the one to try. This is incredible. It gives my life meaning.
After the surgery, I went from 2,800 to 20/20 in my left eye and 20/50 in my right eye. You don't know how much you've given back to my life, our life. So, thank you.
That's why I do this.
This is awesome. I will see you in 3 months with more improvement.
That's right.
I think that I have become a better person for going through the experience of losing vision and going through the darkness and fighting to come out on the other side. And it's given me an opportunity to be a part of this experimental procedure that I think is going to change the world.